So yesterday on MLS News of the Week video, I talk about how the Super Draft was become ever so irrelevant in the league. Ever since now, the league is started to evolve in terms of kind of a selling league, and it's now into an MLS 3.0 stage. And I thought in this video, I'm just going to kind of elaborate more on why I think it started to be a little bit irrelevant. And, you know, I kind of explained that yesterday in my News of the Week episode, but I didn't explain it in a very detailed kind of way. So in this video, I'm going to do exactly that. I'm going to be explaining exactly why I kind of think the draft has kind of been a little bit irrelevant. And before I begin this, let me just say that I'm not really saying that the draft should be just, they should get rid of it because it's absolutely useless and that, you know, we are probably at the end of the era in terms of the Super Draft and that I'm kind of one of those person that opposed the Super Draft. No, I still think it's good that we still have the Super Draft because we have seen teams that are utilizing the Super Draft as a way to build through their squad and basically bring in some very talented youngster in the draft. And the draft doesn't always mean that there's no like good talent in the draft. I mean, guys like Jozy Altidor, Michael Bradley, and even Andre Blake all came out of the draft and they are very talented MLS player. And even recently, Julian Gressel, Tim Parker, Chris Mueller, for example, all guys that came out of the draft, and they are also very talented kind of players. So I'm not saying every player in the Super Draft is just garbage and the fact that they would just go to USL and usually are never going to come back to MLS, but the chances of that actually happening, the chances of teams getting guys in the draft and able to develop them into a good MLS player, it's getting less and less as we go on into the years in MLS and as the league has evolved. So why do I think the draft is irrelevant? First of all, the homegrown rule is one of the big reasons why it started to become a little bit irrelevant. And this also kind of connects to the second reason with the MLS Academy. So ever since the homegrown rule was introduced back, I believe 2008 that they introduced it, basically what this rule is that teams can basically sign youngster from the region the youngster is in. So for example, for the Quakes, they can sign a homegrown player that is based in the San Jose or just based in the Bay Area kind of region, and they can sign him as a homegrown player. And teams can do this with unlimited number of players. There's no limits whatsoever of how many player that is labeled as a homegrown in the roster. And I also think that there's also a rule where it says homegrown player salary does not contribute into the salary cap, which is why a lot of teams have taken advantage of this rule and have signed so many youngsters and bringing into their team and even bringing into the academy. And in this homegrown rule, the other thing that is interesting is that most of the players that team signs are either guys that came out from the academy or academy graduate, or guys that are in the academy but now gone to college, and then the MLS team want to sign these guys that is in college and basically make them a homegrown player. So an example of that was, I remember the Quakes signed JT Marcinkowski as a homegrown player. Marcinkowski was actually with Georgetown, and the Quakes basically just said that, or him actually just said that he wanted left early so that he can join the Quakes as a homegrown player. That's another thing that they can do, and that basically just bypassed the Super Draft. Usually, you know, the Super Draft, like many draft in the American professional sports, usually the draft always look at get guys from college, and basically they go into the draft for teams to basically select it. But nowadays with this homegrown rule, it seems like there is a loophole in a different way where guys are not actually even going to go to the draft anymore, but instead they're going to hope that their team that they are, there's a nearby team or a local team that they are playing soccer with, that that team can basically sign with them as a homegrown player. And talk about the second reason why it's kind of irrelevant with the MLS Academy. You know, more young players are now joining the Academy rather than just have to like wait till college and basically play their professional or just start their professional career there in college. It's not like the NBA or NFL way where, you know, in NFL players usually go to college to start their kind of get ready for their professional football career before going to the draft. It's the same thing with the NBA, but nowadays more young player, and these are not just young player, these are very young player, these are like 13-14 years old that is going to their local team academy and basically decided to join their academy and basically play in the academy and eventually hope that one day they can graduate from the academy and potentially get picked by their local team. Well, because of that, nowadays there is actually less and less players that want to really kind of like go to college to play their college soccer, because the academy basically provide as good a stepping stone to their MLS career as you would be going to college. And some academy also provide some kind of school kind of education for their players. I know the Galaxy, their academy provides some school for those youngsters to basically not only play soccer, but they also get a chance to study at the academy, the same thing. And I think FC Dallas is another one that has a school for their young academy players to learn there. So that's another big reason why the draft is kind of become a little bit irrelevant, because these youngsters are no longer going to have to go to college, but instead just join the academy and hopefully one day either their MLS team, they're gonna pick them up, or the other way that they would do is go overseas. And that's the third reason, because we are seeing some young players that join some MLS academy and then they end up going to Europe, mostly in Germany, as you have heard a lot of different youngsters that used to be in an MLS academy but now are playing in the Bundesliga. And most of the youngsters we had in the US men's national team used to be in an MLS academy but going to Europe now after they graduate. And some people even skip the academy process and just go straight to Europe. So that is why you start seeing some less and less youngster just decided to kind of go to college and go through the draft as a method, but instead they just go through the academy and they hope that they would one day get graduated and the team can basically pick them as a homegrown rule, or they're just going to go overseas to get some experience there. And I think going overseas has been one of the most preferred way if they want to have their talent exposed, because going to Europe, if you're a youngster going to Europe, there is definitely a good chance that if you play well going to Europe, there's a good chance that you could be selected by the national team, which is the ultimate goal of what a American soccer player really wants to do. And then the fourth thing is that the talent pool in the draft has gotten worse throughout the years. And again, this is because of these three reasons, with the homegrown rule and the MLS Academy, with players are kind of skipping the draft, and just even guys that is currently in college are kind of like not really finishing their college career and just jump straight into MLS or going overseas. And that is why it's the talent pool and the guys that is in the draft now are just guys that are either part of an academy, but eventually they decide to go to college, and if they of course didn't get picked by any MLS or didn't really decide to go overseas, so that they might use the draft as a way to get themselves to start an MLS career, which is not a bad choice. But the problem with that is that nowadays, and this is where I'm going to get to the fifth reason, is that most players, they get shipped to USL and never comes back to MLS. So the Super Draft right now, it looks very similar to the MLB draft. And the MLB draft is considered one of those drafts where not a lot of people pay attention to. And there's a good reason why that is the case, because even when MLB team chooses their player in the draft, they just go straight into the minor leagues, and hopefully one day that minor league player can basically make it to the team, which usually never happens. It's the same thing in MLS. Guys go to USL, and basically most of them stay there, and they never come back to MLS. Now, this is not true for every single player. I mean, we have seen before where guys in the USL would have a standout year and eventually come to MLS. And depending on which USL team you join, if you join a USL team that is affiliated with a team that willing to choose some USL players to go into their squad and able to develop them, one prime example of this is the Red Bulls, of how they've been using their USL team and bring some USL guys into their team. And you've seen so far how much that actually have worked. Like, throughout the season, the Red Bulls have picked up a lot of different USL guys that you probably have never heard about, but they were just draft picks a couple of years ago. And it seems that that is a bit successful, but it doesn't always guarantee that. You know, most teams, they don't really look at their USL. Like, for example, the Quakes is another example of that. You know, I think last year when we picked up some of the players in our team, I think almost half or more than half of the player that we picked up in the draft last year didn't even make it to the team, or just cut from the roster by the end of the year. And yeah, that's just an example of what could happen to these players. And our kind of way to doing this is not very uncommon. Other teams also do this. Other teams see that when they pick up guys from the draft and it seemed like they're not good enough, then they will just immediately cut them. So yeah, but then the sixth reason why I think the draft is irrelevant, and this is kind of connect to the next four reason that I'm going to be talking about, is that MLS team no longer uses the draft as a way to build their squad. So if you look at the different ways MLS teams have used to build their squad, it used to be that is the main way to do it. Like, I think back 10 years ago or even 15 years ago when the league was just beginning and it was at the MLS 1.0 stage, teams usually go into the draft and they tends to be very serious and want to pick a guy in the draft so that they can, of course, get that guy into their roster and basically perform. And I think back then there was a lot of MLS team, and I'm not sure if this is true, but most MLS team tends to like tank their season and basically decided to get a better draft pick, something that NFL team, MLB team, and even NBA teams are doing nowadays, where they always just tank their season so that they can get a better draft pick. That's not the case anymore in MLS. Like, no team will actually decide to tank their season, and which is why you never hear the phrase tanking in MLS, because what's the point of tanking your season when you could, all you get is just a number one overall pick that might not always work out very well for you. So that's why MLS team are no longer there to use the draft to, well, MLS team are no longer using the draft as a way to build their squad, because there's now different ways to do it. One of the way is the homegrown way, where they're bringing a lot of these guys that is in their academy and bring those young guys into the team. I know the Union kind of used this way as a prime example to try to build their squad. And then the second way to do it is just spend some money. I mean, ever since the introduction of TAM, GAM, and also the DP slot, teams are spending more and more and just record amount of money on foreign players and just young South American players in South America and bring them to MLS as a way to build their squad. I mean, there's just been like, if you thought this was something that the league would evolve in 10 years ago, you would be just absolutely crazy. But because of the introduction of TAM and GAM, and because now teams actually have money to go into the foreign market and spend their spend on some young player, then they don't need to go to the Super Draft to look for a young player. They could just go to South America, which I said in the News of the Week episode, where I think that's even a more effective way to just go into the draft and look for a young promising player, because in South America, those young talented players are definitely much talented than the guys that we have in the Super Draft. So that's why teams are decided to do that, and this is really now kind of the most primary way of teams trying to get these young guys into their team. And ultimately, the ultimate goal that they're going to do is, you know, they're going to keep them for a couple of years before selling them to a big European team. And that is why MLS right now is kind of turning into a selling league. It's turning into a pipeline where we bring some young talent, get them some experience before shifting them off to Europe to try to earn a profit. Now, even with the same amount of TAM and GAM that each team would get, some teams want to use more TAM than other team would get in order to get those players. So the other way that teams are trying to get more TAM is that they just trade their picks away. Like, their picks is basically their get out of the jail card, or actually that's not really a good way to explain it, but more like a free kind of gold card where they can just use those draft picks as a way to get more TAM. We saw what the Union did just a couple of days ago, where they're able to get some free TAM money just that they can get rid of all that draft pick and all the gold cards that they have to FC Cincinnati to get more TAM money. And teams have also used draft picks as a way to able to get a player from another team. I mean, you look at all those trades that I talk about in the News of the Week this offseason, always involve something about how one team decided to give up their fourth round draft pick for 2020 or 2019 in order to get that player. That way that it will basically lessen the amount of TAM and GAM money team spent, but also it's kind of like now draft picks are not really value anymore, but it's more value kind of like a free gold card where it's worth this kind of amount and we'll just give it to you in order to lessen the TAM and GAM kind of money. And the other way, besides the more TAM money that teams gets for their draft pick or getting rid of those draft picks to get players, the other thing that they use the draft picks for is allocation order, to get them up the allocation order so that they can sign some big kind of star players that used to play in MLS but then go to Europe and now coming back in their later years as good as they were when they start their MLS career, and that's where they want to jump up in the allocation order. So yeah, I hope that kind of explained to you why exactly the Super Draft is becoming a little bit irrelevant nowadays. And again, I'm not saying that we should get rid of the Super Draft. I think there is still a good case of why the Super Draft is still a good thing in MLS, and the fact that, you know, teams still use the Super Draft as a way to bring in guys to their USL team, and hopefully those guys would develop to very good players for their roster. But all I'm saying is, because of so many factors like the homegrown rule, the MLS Academy, the talent pool of the draft just getting worse because of more players decided to go abroad or join a MLS team as a homegrown, or just the fact that teams are really finding a different way to build their roster by just spending money to look for talented player in South America, that is why the draft is started to be a little bit more irrelevant nowadays. But yeah, let me know in the comments below, what do you think of this? And, you know, let me know in the comments below, what's your opinion about the Super Draft? Do you think the Super Draft has become more irrelevant? And how can we change the Super Draft to make it a little bit more relevant again? I mean, it's hard to tweak the system when that is pretty much how the draft works. I mean, the Super Draft that MLS use is very similar to the other draft that the other American professional sports use. So I don't see how they can like tweak it, unless they might tweak the homegrown rule or the MLS academy ways to kind of maybe tweak in a way that it can favorite the Super Draft and make team use the Super Draft more often, which is highly unlikely that MLS is going to do that. But let me know in the comments below, what do you think about this, and what do you think the Super Draft could be improved to make it a little bit more relevant again. And yeah, hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you do, make sure you guys leave a like, smash that subscribe button, and yeah, I will see you guys next time.